extremely difficult to introduce to this field. In many respects, he is an exceptional person. Thereafter, I must tell you that very few doctors have attempted what this young doctor, Sripad Kherekar, has done. He is a regular qualified homeopathic doctor, but what is rare about him, he is one of few doctors who has been able to get MD in homeopathy. He has a big life ahead of him, and I expect that in the future he will be even more successful in achieving, and we will give more encouragement to him so that he is able to achieve his object.
Good afternoon to everyone. Now, when do we go to a doctor? Only when your reports are fine does not mean you are healthy. Only when your counts are good does not mean you are healthy. Because absence of disease or infirmity does not mean that you are healthy. But you have to be physically, mentally and socially fit. Now, are we going in this direction? Do doctors really care that their patients are also socially fit? But what we are doing is we are just going beyond the disease. And that's a part of the definition. This is where I am saying that the scope of a doctor must increase. And we are not just talking about disease, but we are talking about complete cure. We are talking about complete fitness, mental, physical and social well-being. Because doctor has put all this allopath, homeopath, Unani, Ayurveda inside you. And that thing is called your immune system. It is because of your immunity that you've survived. New introduction into your system. So there's a doctor inside and there's a doctor outside. The doctor outside only has to listen to the one inside. Only then there will be a balance. Otherwise there will be no balance. So this is Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, a German scientist, an allopathic doctor himself. He had his top degree during that time and he discovered homeopathy in the year 1796. Fact number one is homeopathy is a German science. Homeopathy has been mentioned in our Vedas. In Rigveda, in the chapter Charaka Samiti, there has been a mention about this science and they've called it Samayaska Shastra, so the science of similars. Now this was something that was very interesting for us to find out, that can be mentioned 5,000 years ago. A German scientist discovered it. So there are so many international stars and celebrities and sports persons who are solely dependent on homeopathy today. Also the president of India has his own homeopathic physician. From the consumer point of view, it is the second most popular system of medicine after Chinese medicine. The word allopathy has been coined by Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, a homeopath himself. Every year, 20,000 new homeopaths are added to our pool. This is the youngest and the latest science of therapeutics, only 250 years old. So it's a very, very small baby and it's only teething. So we don't know how it's going to go, how it's going to get more advanced, as against the so-called modern medicine, which is around for more than 1,000 years. If science has advanced, why are these diseases still not curable? Why are they still controllable? So that was the point why Hahnemann came up with something new. He said that controlling is not the solution, but now we have to talk about complete cure.
So problems like asthma, allergies, recurrent bronchitis, diabetes, hypertension, thyroid problems.
So these are only controllable, not curable. And that was the entire point. Vaccination is the invention of the century. And how many of us know that vaccination is nothing but a part of a homeopathic principle? Because for a simple fact that here you are taking help of the immune system. You are stimulating the immune system. That's why you don't get a particular illness. There is no drug given to you. A particular type of immunoglobulin is stimulated and then diseases can be completely eradicated. And homeopathy was discovered much way before vaccination, 250 years ago. Vaccination was discovered 100 years ago. Whenever a baby is born, the head always comes out first. For a simple reason, that it is the most important part of your body. And whenever the feet come out, what do we say? Breach. That means something is wrong. Even your smile is decided by your genes. So that's what a homeopath is trying to do. He's trying to observe you. He's trying to understand what is your genetic makeup. What are you made up of? Accordingly, I can give you a remedy which is going to stimulate your immune system. I'm not going to treat your disease. No, definitely not. Because when I treat your immune system, disease will be taken care of by itself. Simple. It is the same genetic code that will be common to your hair as well as your neuron or to your hepatocyte. Because this entire human body, trillions of cells have come from one cell. Because this cell has given jobs, okay, you have to become your skin, you have to become your brain or your liver or your kidneys or whatever. With the help of modern technology, they could understand the facts. So that's what I'm trying to do. I'm trying to understand homeopathy
with whatever modern sciences we have. Now we have the luxury of understanding genetics, the luxury of understanding proteomics. Now there are great schools like Harvard Medical School or Massachusetts General Hospital, John Hopkins. So all of them are doing research. I'm just trying to apply that research to a science which is 250 years old. That's all I'm doing, nothing else.
You have heard many inspiring lectures from many doctors, but one of the most inspiring lectures I heard today.